What's going on, everybody? Welcome back to the BTR Garage. My name is Justin. In today's video, we have something very cool for you. We're gonna be doing our first ever test of my oil pressure logging on my GR86. We're briefly gonna show you how we got it set up. Obviously, we have an oil pressure sensor and a few other parts to make it work, along with the race chrono setup that I showed you guys in a video a little while back. This is gonna allow us to log oil pressure in the car, whether we're on the racetrack or the autocross course or virtually any other situation as well. And then after that, we're gonna take it for a drive through the canyons and show you what the oil pressure results look like on the first test drive. So the kit that I opted for to get oil pressure data into my GR86 is this kit from GJP Products. This is the GJP IO box. It basically takes the sensor data from the oil pressure sensor here, translates it into CAN data for the CAN bus, and allows you to connect the OBD2 Bluetooth adapter and then attach that to whatever software program you would like. In my case, we're going to be using Race Chrono. We also need this little part that came with the kit, which is the adapter plug that attaches to the block itself or the engine block itself. And then the sensor goes into the top port. We're going to go ahead and get this stuff installed. It's super easy, very quick. We're going to get Race Chrono set up and show you how it all works. We'll make our way over to the car. I'm going to show you where to install the oil pressure sensor itself and then the GJP box as well. But if we look down in between the intake pipe here, that Allen key plug right down there. So that guy we're going to remove. That's an 8mm Allen key head. Once we have that plug removed, we're going to put the brass adapter in there, followed by the oil pressure sensor itself. And if we back out, show you where the GJP IO box is going to go. We're gonna put that over on the shock tower. So on my car, we're gonna put it on this end bolt here, but we'll go ahead and get the parts and start getting things installed. The last thing we need to do is set up the IO box with whatever logger we happen to be using. In my case, we're using Race Chrono. You can also use the Solo 2 DL as well as Torque Pro. But essentially what you have to do is go in and set up all of the different CAN IDs in the Race Chrono application settings. GJP provides a detailed table with all of the CAN IDs and equations that you need to input. It makes it very easy to set up. Now you're all set to get the car started up for the first time. Be sure to check for any oil leaks, and it's time to go for a drive. For my first oil pressure logging test, I hit up one of the canyons that I frequent pretty regularly, so I know it very well. But keep in mind, this is a semi-spirited drive. It's not a full-blown 10-tenths race up the mountain, so keep that in mind. There are some tighter and slower sections of the canyon where, while we are hitting 1 to 1.1 Gs of lateral G, we're still low in the RPM range and that kind of thing. So do keep that in mind throughout the video. That said, I do think this is a pretty good example of a typical canyon drive that most of us might do on the weekend. Being safety conscious and not overdoing it, we've got all the nannies on the car still on, and we're just out enjoying a good solid canyon run. So I'm gonna stop talking for a few minutes. You guys can observe the oil pressures and other data on the screen, and I'll catch you in a minute in the closing. So there we go, everybody. That is the first test of oil pressure logging on my GR86. Like I said, this is just the start. We're gonna do more testing on the track with different sets of tires to try out different grip levels to see if that affects the oil pressures. So stay tuned for that. Hopefully we get those baseline numbers in very soon. And then I also already have a Kazama oil pan baffle on the way. We're gonna test that out as well, see what kind of improvements we get, if any, with the oil pressure from that. So thanks everybody for watching once again. If you have any thoughts, comments, or questions, please leave them down below. I would love to hear from you. Again, stay tuned. We got more stuff coming up very soon. Stay safe out there. I am checking out. Talk to you all next time.